Let's understand about the Java Persistent API or JPA. You know, JPA is a Java API specification for relational data management in application using Java SE and Java EE. JPA defines a standard way for simplifying database programming for developers, reduce development time and increase productivity. As of now, the latest version of JPA specification is 2.2. However, in this project, we use JPA version 2.1 because it's the version supported by Hibernate Framework. And when using JPA, we have to import classes and interface that are defined in the package Java X.persistence. JPA defines the Java Persistent Query Language, or JPQL. JPQL is an object-oriented query language that is used to make queries against entities stored in a relational database. JPQL syntax is similar to SQL, but it operates against Java objects rather than directory with a database table. And remember that JPA is a specification and its implementation include Hibernate, EclipseLink, and OpenJPA. And here's a couple of examples that give you how the code looks like if using the JPA. This here, a model class annotated using a JPA annotation. You see this class book is mapped to the table book in the database using the annotation SI entity. And the field book ID is mapped to the book underscore ID column in the database using the SI column annotation. The annotation SI ID indicates that this column is a primary key. Similarly, the field title is mapped to the title column in the database using the annotation SI column. And this here symbol JPQL query select B from book B order by B dot title. You see, it looks very similar to SQL, but you see the object oriented syntax here. B dot title. This query retrieves all books and sorts them by title into ascending order. The book here is not a table in the database. Instead, it is a book. It is a book entity class here. So that gives you an overview about JPA. Next, let's understand about Hibernate Framework. You know, Hibernate is a popular object relational mapping framework that simplifies database programming for developers. Hibernate Framework was developed before JPA and after JPA becomes a standard and becomes a specification, Hibernate restructures itself to become an implementation or provider of JPA. That means we can use Hibernate independently or use it as an implementation of a JPA. Hibernate framework consists of several components. The first one is Hibernate ORM or Hibernate Object Relational Mapping. Hibernate ORM is the core of the framework on which other components depend. We use Hibernate ORM for mapping Java model classes to tables in a relational databases. And Hibernate Search is a full text search component for domain model. Hibernate Validator is a component for making constraints for domain model. And Hibernate OGM is a domain model persistent component for NoSQL databases. And Hibernate Tools is a set of blockchains for Eclipse IDE, facilitating Hibernate development within Eclipse. It provides mapping editor, control reverse engineering. And in this project, we use only Hibernate ORM and Hibernate tools, as you will learn shortly in this video.